Phil Spencer talks PS5's approach to gaming and more. Let's get into it. What is going on, guys? Dealer back again with yet another video. Shout out to Open Mic. Check his music out. Link down below. And of course, today we're talking about one of the latest Phil Spencer interviews. Sorry, I can't just do videos whenever. But you know, at the end of the day, we had to address a lot of people that tried Hooked on Phonics and it didn't work for them. So I'm convinced that they tried to read these articles and just fail completely. It's almost like they're pretending not to interpret things correctly or really think about the fact that Sony have already talked about them doing the same thing or that they are already doing parts of the same thing. I really don't care anymore. You know, half the time, a lot of these guys are not even paying attention or they're lying about half the crap we say anyway. So you know what? We're going to go ahead and talk about that today. Have a little bit of fun. If you end up liking the video, hit the like button, show a buddy or two, subscribe. Let's get into it. GamesIndustry.biz did an interview with Phil Spencer where he does talk about things like the July 23rd event. Not anything too substantial there. He did talk about how, hey, we enabled our studios and we gave more time and better quality and they're taking risks and it looks amazing. That shit looks fire. Look, I'm not even going to cover that article. I'll link it down below. That's common sense. We've been talking about that forever. Now, what I do want to talk about is Xbox don't like how Sony are doing their exclusives and how people have a problem with this. No more exclusives for you. It's like, holy, Xbox hasn't had exclusives since 2015. Welcome to 2020. If there are a few bullet points next to Phil Spencer on Tinder, they say, love being able to keep my old games. Actually enjoy flexibility and compatibility. Want extremely powerful hardware that will apparently be held back. Why did we invest all this money in this hardware? And the last bullet point, of course, would be love being taken out of context and misunderstood by the ill-educated. So the interview people couldn't really read or comprehend correctly of, you know, Xbox's Phil Spencer says PS5 style next generation exclusives are counter to what gaming is about. They took from the fact that Phil Spencer said, you know what, you should be able to keep your games. You should be able to keep them games and use them and have what you paid for. A lot of people had a problem with that. Yes, they had a problem with this. And they said, you know what, Phil? I don't like that. I like to be cut off. I like to be forced. I like to look at games and really just lie about how they look next gen, even though they don't really look next gen, and justify my purchase of a PS5 through the power of feeling like I'm smarter than everyone else. I'm getting both. Are you? Oh, you playing on a PC? Why are you doing that? It's held back. It's all held back, right? I mean, Xbox is literally copying that model. Oh, wait, it's not about power? Okay, why are you getting a PS5? Oh, you got a PS4 Pro? You got an Xbox One X? You got a 2080? No, it's about power and the games. See, me and myself, I've always asked for both power and games. When it comes down to it, as I'll go into more later, nothing shown on the PS5 really looked all that next gen, especially when you compare two different games from both Xbox Series X and PS5 and talk about, hey, which one looks better? Yes, one's not really the final product yet, but you are silly if you don't think Hellblade will look at least close to this good being played in real time on stage. You clearly don't know anything about the hardware Microsoft are packing. So Phil was talking about Sony's approach to next generation. Rather, he was asked about this. Phil Spencer says being held back is a meme at this point, meaning he thinks it's funny. He thinks you guys are funny. He thinks you're clowns, I would assume anyway. He says it is a meme created by those that are caught up in device competition, meaning fanboys. Now, I know at least, I don't know, four of you are going to call me a fanboy because I'm talking about this in the way that I am. But at the end of the day, I give praise to both sides where it's due. Look at my backlog. If you haven't and you're still talking, smack yourself in the lips. Phil Spencer continues by talking about the compatibility among PC, how it has had this compatibility for decades and not held anything back. There is a reason that your 3080, which will be announced soon, should do a lot better in games than your 2080. And when it comes to all games, every game, most of them are on PC. All of those games have a lowest common denominator, every multiplat. When it comes down to it, Phil knows that they are going to show you some of the best looking games you've ever seen in your life. They all run on the original 2013 Xbox One. That is a mega L for all of you already. You can then proceed to talk about budgets, team size, and more, but when it comes down to it, Naughty Dog games look so amazing because of their budget, team size, and more. The proprietary technology, it all comes together, and you put out what you put out. Phil also knows that they are going to show you frame rates that you have never seen on more games than you can really even imagine. 60 FPS as the standard regarding Xbox games, at least from them. The hardware is more than capable. And guess what? They're going to make sure you know that this month. Look, I'm not even going to bring up the fact that nothing shown on PS5 so far even looks all that next gen either. And that's countering the fact that you're going to talk about how Halo Infinite doesn't look X, Y, or Z, even though you didn't really watch the 4K trailer, you watched the stream and never looked at it again. Even though it was running at double the frame rate of anything we've seen on the PS5 right now from Sony, except for maybe the racing game, Gran Turismo. Even though it actually does feature ray tracing, unlike anything from the first party that we've really seen too much of from Sony. I mean, countering Ratchet and Clank, but look at Ratchet and Clank. I get it. You're not going to get props where you really aren't forced to. You never do. You never have. But at the end of the day, as somebody who really likes things about both platforms, but ultimately prefers the Xbox, I gotta tell you, shit is cringy. Just stop, you know? Really, when it comes down to Phil's quotes regarding their new games, you guys didn't even read it correctly half the time, let alone even understand that they already talked about how their games will work on older platforms for 1 year, maybe two. After that, it all moves up to 8-core, 16-thread, SSD-based game design. And again, GPU things are not held back to begin with. Those of you crying about this, do you not remember talking about how this stuff will work on the older platforms for a little bit? All right. Also consider the fact that we don't know exactly what's happening with PS5 and what games will and will not work on PS4. We know certain games definitely should work on PS4. There is no technical reason that we can spot. There is no extraordinary game design. And as I mentioned before, the graphics don't even look all that much different. I am getting a lot of these games on PS5 day one. I'm definitely getting Horizon Zero Dawn. Never said these games don't look good. I know how people like to take things to the extreme. I'm just saying, hey, think a little bit before you talk, because both platforms offer great things. And as a fan, the absolute most that you should feel like you have to do every day on YouTube, every day on Twitter, is not bash the other one. This isn't 2014. It's maybe ask the other one, hey, maybe do something that you don't do the best. Do it better. Compete. It's all about competition. But again, let me know what you think about all this, guys. Video's kind of off the cuff today. Let me know what you think about that. I might do more of these. And, you know, I try not to do it in a toxic way. But, man, I was born to talk shit. I just, if you watch the podcast, you know that. I just, it's hard to contain it sometimes. Because you'll watch 5 seconds of these guys talk. And you're like, holy crap, you're wrong 6 times. So, you know, once more, hit that like button if you enjoyed the video. Show a buddy or two. Subscribe for more. Hit that bell icon. If you want to become a patron, if you want to support content like this, hit that link down below, Patreon link down below. There is a channel membership button as well. You guys power this content. If you want more of it, let me know. Again, article link down below. I'm Dealer. Let's keep some common sense in the community here. I'm out.